there, I'm Jennifer from savorwithjennifer.com, and today we are making lemon blueberry pound cake. It's a delight. So to begin, we have a 9 by 5 inch bread pan, loaf pan, whatever you would like to call it. And to that, we are going to very thoroughly grease the sides and bottom with 2 tablespoons of butter. It's easiest if your butter's room temperature, and I like to use either napkins or paper towels to wipe it around. Pound cake is it can be very sticky, so making sure your loaf pan is well greased is definitely a high priority. I like to use butter for greasing this particular cake because the butter flavor on the crust makes it golden and crumbly and delicious and just much better than spraying it with Pam. Next, we're going to whisk together our dry ingredients and then put them to the side while we work on our wet ingredients. I have 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder. To that, we're going to add 1 1/4 cups of flour. Going to whisk these together and then set them to the side until our wet ingredients are ready, and then we're going to add them in batches. For the next step in our cake batter, we're going to add 1/3 cup of room temperature butter to our mixing bowl and 1 1/4 cups of sugar. This recipe also has a really nice amount of fresh squeezed lemon juice and lemon zest. So while it seems like maybe a little bit too much sugar, it perfectly balances the tart and the lemon, which gives it a really fantastic freshness and just intense flavor. We're going to whip this on a medium speed for about 3 to 6 minutes until it's incredibly light and fluffy. The color will change the longer you whip it, and we're looking for that really light color. Next, we're going to add our eggs 1 at a time and mix just until the yellow and the yolk starts to blend. I'm going to take a microplane grater and I'm going to zest lemon 1 to 2 in order to get 1 1/2 tablespoons of zest. A microplane grater is my favorite tool for zesting fruit. We're going to add our lemon zest directly to the egg, sugar, and butter mixture. The lemons that you just zested, we're going to cut in half, juice them, and we need 1/4 cup of fresh squeezed lemon juice to add to our cake batter. All right, let's see where we're at. Right at 1/4 cup, we're gonna go ahead and add that to our batter, and then next, one of the main secrets to this cake recipe, sour cream. I'm going to go ahead and turn my mixer on medium low, and as the zest and juice and sour cream begin to mix in, I'm going to add my dry ingredients in batches. We're going to only mix until everything is just combined. Do not continue to mix past that because you don't want to make tough batter. Okay, batter is just mixed in. Everything looks perfect. Next, we're going to add our blueberries. We're going to add 1 cup gently folded into this cake batter. We're going to put it into our loaf pan, and then we're going to sprinkle the remaining blueberries on top. Blueberries tend to sink because they're kind of weighty. So to help prevent that, or at least minimize it, we're going to dust them with a little bit of flour first before we mix them in, before we fold them into our cake batter. I'm going to add about 1/2 tablespoon of flour. Stir to coat them. 1 cup of these are going to go straight into the batter. I'm going to gently fold them in. All right, blueberries are folded in. We're going to go ahead and put our batter into our cake pan. Kind of shake it up a little bit to make sure your batter is distributed evenly throughout the pan. That looks like a delight. Next, we're going to take the remainder of our half cup of blueberries, sprinkle them on top. All right, we're gonna put this in a 325 degree oven, low and slow until the toothpick inserted in the center comes out clean. See you in a bit. This looks pure perfection. We're going to let this cool for about 10 minutes before running a knife around the edge. And while that cools all the way off, we're going to talk about our glaze. Let's get started. Our glaze is going to be 1.5 cups of powdered sugar. We're gonna put it in a bowl, and then into that we are going to whisk lemon juice and lemon zest. 2 or 1.5 cups of brown sugar. We're going to add 1.5 tablespoons of lemon zest, and then 3 tablespoons of lemon juice. Again, we're going to use our microplane grater. All right, in goes the lemon zest. Next, we're going to slice the lemons we just zested and juice them until we have 3 tablespoons of lemon juice. We need 3 tablespoons of lemon juice. Perfect. It doesn't look like enough liquid, but stir it, and trust me, it is. Perfect lemon drizzle. All right, now, we have our cake. It's rested for about 10 minutes until it starts to kind of pull away from the edges of the cake pan. We're going to flip it on our cooling rack and let it finish cooling. Once it's all the way cool to room temperature, we're going to drizzle it with our lemon glaze. If you choose to, you can garnish with fresh blueberries or pieces of lemon peel, but it doesn't need to be that. I hope you enjoy. Oh yeah.